Welcome to the Machine Learning at Home. Today I will show some more exotic methods of machine learning. Last time it was automated learning, and today it will be leveraged and educated learning. So these both types of learning, leveraged and educated, are mostly based on dimension reduction. So this is a process when we take some multi-dimensional data like 3, 4, 500 columns and then reduce it to like 2 or 3 columns, which will make this data much more accessible, like both to humans and to more advanced methods. So let us do it. So first of all, like for all machine learning, we need a subsets. So today I will give you another method of subsets. So we'll make a sampling vector of 1 to 150 with exact division to 5 equal to 0. A bit crazy, is it? So what is it? It is some, like this, see it. Truths and falses, as usual. So what's going on? We take numbers from 1 to 150 and then divide it exactly on 5. So, and then when there is no remaining, this will be true. If anything is left, then will be false. So 5 will be dividable to 5 exactly, so it will result in true. Whereas 6 is not dividable to 5 exactly, so it will be false. So easy enough, I hope. And this is a new method of doing the same sampling. Plus, I will do something different with our object. So I will make a variable new and will read in it species variable from the same RS data. And then I will replace those members of new which are reversal to sam into missing data. So it's better to show than to tell, probably. So I take new, then select those part of new which are not truths, so exclamation mark for negation in sam. So all these falses, all these falses will be selected in that case, and I will select them and replace to NA. NA is a special word in R and means non-available. So this is a missing data, so it will be missed. So now head of new will look like NA and CITOSA. So because CITOSA corresponds with true, and an ace will correspond with all these falses. All right, so now I'm going to show you how these learnings look like. I will need my library, Shipunov, and then I will need the function which we didn't work with yet, function called class approach. So this is educated approach. So I will educate class approach with those species labels which are left in my new data. So my new data contains some species label, but it's mostly an ace. So these species labels which are still here will be used for education, as I call it. So iris without variable number 5, I will teach it on my variable new. And of course I will read it and I will write it in some new object, iris CLE, E for educated. Okay. And important, because we are dealing with a dimension reduction, important is to plot it. So plot iris CLE. I need a part of it which has a name, projection. And then I will colorize it. I will colorize it in, again, some slightly unusual ways. So color will be equal to something like iris species, but type of dot PCH will be from the function if else, and it will be if else related with our sampling vector SAM. So if our sampling is true, then it will be point number 19, fillet circle. If it is false, it will be empty circle. So I will see in those places which correspond with truth, with known labels, I will see fillet circles. And on those places which correspond with NAs or falses in SAM vector, I will see non-filled, empty circles. Let us look on it now. So this is it. As you see here, these filled circles were used for education. So ClassProj was educated on our filled circle, true species label data, and make our data separated because it was educated to distinguish between three different species. As you probably remember, black correspond with Setosa, red with Versicolor, and green with Virginica, simply because they are in alphabetical order. And black, red, green are three colors: color number 1, number 2, and number 3 in R. So this is I call educated approach. So we use species label to make some projection which will take it into account. By the way, it's a very good way to plot almost any clusters. So, but educated way is more exotic. More often people use leveraged way. So this is simpler. We simply say iris CLL for leveraged will be iris class projection, class proj, from all iris variable except number 5, and we will simply use variable number 5 for leveraged approach. In that case, this is not exactly education. We simply tell, directly tell, okay, place these species apart as much as possible. So this is what we do right now. And then we will plot it in a similar way, but we don't need to distinguish now between types of dots. They all actually filled circles. 19 will be, and of course we should replace CLE to CLL. All right, CLL, or CL, I named it, that's why. Okay, now we should have plotting. It's slightly different, but similar in general, and now we use all species labels to make this plot as distinguishing species clouds as possible. So this is a class projection approach. So very similar result might be achieved with linear discriminant analysis. It also returns some class projection, which might be used for plotting different classes. So LDA by default, if you teach LDA on a whole data set, might be leveraged method. You can also make educated method of LDA, but LDA idea is a bit different, so better to use more specialized methods. So this is how educated approach, when we use just a few of all species labels, and leveraged approach when we use all species labels, to change the projection dimension reduction in such a way that it will reflect species, multiple different entries, much better. So this is a difference from kind of blind projection way, which is a principal component analysis PCA. So, and if you look on the PCA in comparison with what we did today, PCA will work much worse than that. This approach will separate species better. So, this is it for today. Thank you very much.